Did you play an active part in the Second World War?
I was an air raid warden.
Can you tell me about your work?
When the sirens went in September, when it was announced that the war was declared, I was in the Donnell Road, what was the boat school, taken over by the ARP. And I was all day, from morning right up to dinner time, fitting gas masks on the general public. And I was fitting them all day.
What else were your duties?
As a warden, I was in charge of about a dozen men, wardens, and we used to take the stirrup pumps out to different places so that if there was any fire or anything, the neighbours could help themselves. We taught them how to use them. I used to give lectures on at the Kongs and in various houses all about it.
When the sirens went, where were the sirens situated, first of all?
The sirens were situated here, one of them, Davy Lawyers, which were Davy Brothers then.
Well, what about air raid shelters? Was there a communal shelter around
there?
Here?
A communal shelter just across the road there. A friend of mine, he died the other week. He was in charge of that. He got the key, but he lived up James Street. I was the nearest, and the next door neighbours, they hadn't a shelter of their own, and they used to go over there. And when I used to go out, they used to play pot with me because I couldn't let them in. And this chappy up there had the key.
So what happened when there was an air raid? What were your duties during the air raid?
As an air raid patrolman, we used to go about all over the shore because I couldn't stand the shelter in any case.
Mm. So you used to be out around, yes.
Walking around, yes. Mm. And in the Blitz in Sheffield, on the Thursday night, the first Blitz we had, I was uptown, and all the workmen were working, and they went and under shelter, under the twist drill. Well, I went out on the streets, and I got one or two firebombs out, and then the bombs kept coming down, and I was in a house, and it was all ablaze, and all we could do was bring the furniture out to help, because they'd fractured the water mains, you see. There were no water. And then I was in school. I don't know how I got there. There were all wardens in, and a bomb dropped on Pomona Street. And we got down, as we were told, to cover a, you know. And I had all glass pitted in my hand, and it swelled up. Then, after, I went out into the street, and the bomb had dropped somewhere at the back of the houses, and it had left all the lights on, and I went in the houses, and all the furniture, things were all cluttered. It had blown all the pictures off the wall, and they're all in the middle of the floor. So I went and took the bulb out, and I found myself walking around the street with the bulb in my hand. And everybody had gone. The wardens that I was with had all gone. I never saw many more. Mm-hmm. And I walked home at 6 o'clock in the morning from twist drill, and I came up the moor, and everything was ablaze and all glass and things all over. And I walked all the way home, and I went to bed, and I was black, absolutely black. And I got up and went up round about and told them all that had happened. And I said, please get some water outside. because there's no chance if there's a fire, if they fracture the water mains. And they did that, and there was a great help to me.
Sounds so. It was a very difficult time during the Blitz.
Yes, people. Very difficult, yes.